On this edition of Inside Blue Host Football, Presbyterian College hosts a hot Kennesaw State team for homecoming. And what's the opposite of homecoming? Going on the road, something the Blue Hosts will do this Saturday for the first time since week one. We'll talk about those games with head coach Tommy Spangler, as well as check out the highlights, big plays, and everything else you've come to love on this edition of Inside Blue Host Football. Welcome to Inside Blue Hose Football. We're going to talk about Presbyterian College football. We'll talk about the Kennesaw State Owls, the Monmouth Hawks, and any other birds we want to talk about. But, Coach, we'll talk about that game on Saturday with Coach Tommy Spangler. It was, not the game you wanted. You held them early, and then they were able to put some points on the board.
Yeah, you got to give Kennesaw some credit. Kind of a new program, but they sure have arrived.
Sure.
You know, they've gotten there quickly, and they've got nice resources, and they've got some pretty good players. But you're right, Ryan. We started out awesome. Defense was really playing well, shutting them down. What was disappointing was the score right before half that kind of lost momentum for us, kind of tough to overcome at halftime. But I was proud of the way our kids played, the way they battled. We had our chances. Obviously, we turned it over too many times. But really, when you analyze the game, it wasn't like Kennesaw was big playing us left and right.
Right.
They were methodical with pounding the ball on us a little bit, and our kids kept fighting and scrapping and clawing. And I tell you what, amongst a little bit of the clutter that's going on with our program right now, I'm real proud of our guys. I think everybody out there ought to be proud of our guys. And if you get a chance to see one of our players, tell them how much you appreciate them and what they're doing for our school, because our kids came to battle. Now, obviously, we weren't happy with the score, but there again, I keep saying it every week, there's that inner lion feeling by me that we are improving, we are getting better, we're just not quite where we need to be yet.
And of course, Kennesaw State now breaking into the coaches' poll for the first time in program history. Monmouth also doing that as well, and we'll talk about the Hawks later in the program. But like you said, you were limiting the chunk plays, you held them to 7 points, in the first half until that last one, which they have never been shut out in the first half, so you guys were close to that. And the offense was able to move the ball, just not able to put it in.
Yeah, and it was a little bit like, Charleston Southern. Mm-hmm. We had some yards, we moved the ball, we ran it fairly effectively, we threw it fairly effectively, we just couldn't get it in the end zone. And bottom line is, you got to score points. And last I looked, the team that had the most points wins, So we've got to keep working, got to stay confident. The offense doesn't need to beat themselves up too bad, other than just finding a way that, hey, when we get move the ball, between the 30s, we're really pretty good. Mm-hmm. It's just when we get it inside the 30, we have a tendency to either stall or turn it over and so forth. But there were some good things, and we'll see some good highlights of some really solid play and some guys playing the game the way it's meant to be played with great effort.
Well, that sounds great to me. Let's go ahead and take a look at those offensive highlights from the game against Kennesaw State.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
Ryan, here are some of our offensive highlights. This opening drive, we had kicked off. We got a three and out, which doesn't happen to Kennesaw much. And here's Ben dropping back and hitting Keith Pearson for a big third and five gain, which gained good yardage, got us across midfield. There again, we got to stay consistent on continuing these. This is an awesome play against a good defense to convert this. Really a good route, good ball. Does something with it after the catch, and a good game for us. Here we go here. This is Deshaun Davis. You know, we keep talking about him, and he kind of sneaks out in the flat there, and Ben puts it on him, and he gets a good gain there for about 10 yards, and we're continuing to move the football. You know, I like the approach we had. I like the plan we had. And I felt that Kennesaw State was somewhat on their heels early in the game, Ryan, and we weren't able to kind of put the ball in the end zone and put them away, so to speak. Here's a big completion to Darquez Watson. Big 11-yard catch, gets a first down. We had some first downs. Mm-hmm. We moved the ball. Like I said, if the field was 60 yards long, we'd have several points, mm-hmm. but it's not. You know, we're pretty good between the 30s, and we seem to stall a little bit, but we just got to keep working. And, you know, this was when Will came in. You can see the lefty there, the southpaw firing it out there and doing a good job. Here was another third and 10 completion to Seth Frazier. And we actually had a little spark. We had a little life going. There's Will hitting him, and then Seth doing a really good job of making some guys miss and picking up 10 yards and getting us a first down. So I felt when we made the move to go with Will, Ben's done a great job. We went with Will. It gave us some life, but at the same time, Will's got to be able to take our football team down and put us in the end zone. This was a really good, one of our longest gains of the day. It was a 29-yard reception to Day-Day, and kind of laid it up, see it wide open across the middle of the field, and lays it in there. And, you know, Day-Day's fighting. They still don't have him down. And, you know, we're driving. You know, we're thinking, okay, let's knock one in. Let's get some momentum going. Maybe get them on their heels a little bit. But we just never were able to put the ball in the end zone there. And then this last highlight is a nice 15-yard run by Mark Robinson. You know, what a bull. You know, Mark's got a little of the fumbleitis that we got to get out of him. I think the only way you do that is just trying to build the kid's confidence and be smart and continuing to build on fundamentals, on ball security and so forth. But the guy ran hard, and we just kept giving it to him because he was running hard. There's a great cut, and then he just trucks a guy and keeps plowing. So good run by Mark.
Some big plays on offense. And Coach, you kind of addressed the thing we were going to talk about, which is, you know, you made a quarterback change, and then Mark Robinson had a great game up until that fumble.
Yeah, we felt like it was time to go with Will. Ben's done a good job. You know, everybody always loves the second quarterback. Mm-hmm. You know how that goes, Ryan. And anytime you struggle a little bit with the first, everybody wants the second. But felt like Will's deserved the shot there. And like you said, Mark was running well and doing a great job for us. He just happened to cough the ball up, and that's been three straight weeks. He's got to get it fixed.
What makes the red zone so difficult, and how are you able to kind of address that?
Well, I think, number one, the field shrinks and the defense can tighten up. Mm-hmm. You know, no longer the deep balls are threatening and that type of thing. So we just got to go out and practice red zone offense and focus on scoring points, you know. I wish I had the exact answer. I probably wouldn't be sitting here with you if I did. But, you know, it's just a matter of continue to work on it, focus on it, emphasize it, ball security. Not every time it's going to be a touchdown. We got to get some field goals. But at the same time, we got to get some points.
Sure. Name of the game, like you said, is putting points on the board. All right, we're going to take our first break. When we come back, we're going to talk about the defensive highlights, special teams highlights, and, of course, that collision of the week. That's when we return in just a moment to Inside Blue Hose Football.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge. And now, with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
As you set your financial game plan, we'll be with you every play. Relax, you're with Founders.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Coca-Cola, taste the feeling. And by Adidas, here to create.
Welcome back to Inside Blue Hose Football. We're talking Presbyterian College football and the game against Kennesaw State. And Coach, I really felt early on that first quarter, really that first drive, it really felt like you kind of punched Kennesaw State in the mouth a little bit.
We did. I thought we had the momentum, and obviously we came to play and maybe knocked them on their heels a little bit, so to speak. So I like the way our guys responded. We had a great week of practice. Our guys, 48 hours out with their mental approach and so forth, was really good. Came out strong. You know, it just seemed like maybe that little bit of lull right before half. Ben throws the interception. They take it down and score right before half. Kind of like took some air out of us a little bit. Now, it's easy to say don't let it take it out of you, but that happens a little bit. And we went into halftime rather than maybe 7-0 down, 7-3, 10-7, that kind of thing, which it probably should have been. Mm-hmm. We're down now 14-0. And you know, against a good team like Kennesaw State, that's tough.
Sure, absolutely. Well, there were a lot of great plays on defense. Let's check out a couple of them with the defensive highlights against Kennesaw State.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
Ryan, here we are on defense. We actually acted like we knew what we were doing here early. You know, we were making some plays and getting after it, and this was a really good job by Jicey Yeldell and Michael Branch for a tackle on a third and six, you know. And why they didn't throw the football here, I don't know, but they felt like they can run the ball, get the first down. We strung it out, and we rallied to the ball and got some blue jerseys, some white helmets. That's a good look right there, and some guys playing excited, and we're doing some good things. I still think we haven't given up a first quarter touchdown in about three games. That was third and short, and great solo tackle by KJ Presley out of Alabama, and big play right there. We had him flustered a little bit with some movement that we were doing with the DL there early in the game. Here's a good play by Rock. He kind of spins out of it a little bit, but you can see he's charging up the field, knifes through, gets the guy on the ground for basically a tackle for a loss, flying around. Guys are chasing, staying alive. It's a tough offense to play, and it's unique, but, you know, we have seen it a couple times this year. Here's a third and four. They try to get the ball on the edge, all right, and Eli Turner comes from his safety spot. Brian Washington is there for a tackle for loss. So, you know, doing some good things. Proud of our guys, where they're playing, how they're playing hard, continuing to build, continuing to improve. It just seemed to be that little lull in the third quarter that we've got to be able to overcome. Here's a true freshman, Dirk Curitan from Charlotte. They throw one out in the flat. He comes up and sticks the guy pretty good, knocks it loose. Got to continue to get more of that. But there again, a true freshman. The guy, I guess, is shaving maybe. A young guy that's going to continue to develop for us. And then here's a tremendous – this Sumter guy, Ryan, and you know about him, is kind of their go-to guy down here. And Rock Yassin had him just guarded well and had actually a chance, the more I look at it, to intercept it, you know. But I think he was more focused on breaking it up.
You know, Coach, that last play, if you'd have told me, if I saw the end and looked the other way, I would have thought Rock might have been the receiver, and he was holding off the DB there. He's been such a good player back there for you.
He's been awesome, and he's going to be a guy that, you know, with another, obviously finishing this year, next year, he'll have a chance to possibly play at the next level, I think. He's that good of a player and that good of a defender and that good of a kid. He works his butt off, and, he was asked to shut down 15 had one catch, actually beat Eli on a ball, not Rock. So Rock kind of went with him all day and pretty much shut him down.
Less than 100 yards in the air for Kennesaw State. That's great to see. Now, let's transition and take a look at the special teams highlights from the game against Kennesaw State.
here we are on special teams. Won the toss finally, deferred, and elected to kick off. And Timmy Hartshorn does a great job. This is good coverage, too, by our guys getting down the field. And he pumps the ball in the back of the end zone. You can see us running through and playing hard. And I think that says a lot to open the game by drilling one deep, getting some guys hustling down the field, pouring through their protection, and good job by Timmy Hartshorn. And then here's a nice punt. They were kind of shifted over. We usually like to pooch kick this, Ryan, and I saw the guy shifted over there, so I told him to kick it high, and he did, and it was could have been a deeper punt, but obviously he didn't want to kick it in the end zone, so it was a great hang time, a great 39-yard punt, and our guys, you can see, getting down the field, hustling, trying to create a tough situation for Kennesaw coming off.
Anytime you can take the return out of the equation, that's good for a couple of reasons. Number one, because you can have some big hits. Let's take a look at a big hit from that game with the Collision of the Week.
Collision of the Week is brought to you by Hannah Heating and Air.
All right, here's our favorite part, the collision of the week, Ryan. And this is Grant Bidle shooting the A-gap and just nailing the fullback, you know. And by the time the guy got the handoff, Grant's helmet was in his face. So it's just a big hit, a big play. You know, great job by him.
Grant Bidle there, he had 16 tackles, and I think that one might have been one of his favorites. All right, we're going to take our final break. When we come back, we're going to take a look at the health of the Blue Hose at the Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report, our coach's corner, and our look ahead to Monmouth. That's when we return to Inside Blue Hose Football.
I'm a random windstorm. Shaky, 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 shaky. Shaky, shaky. And if you got cut rate insurance, you could be picking up this tab yourself. So get Allstate. You could save some cash and be better protected from mayhem like me.
Watching a cow.
Oh, what's it doing?
Impressions.
Power up your morning with a new 300-calorie egg white grill. Only at Chick-fil-A.
Tailgating is a song heard from Alabama to the Carolinas and everywhere in between. They say this song can be heard elsewhere, and perhaps this is true, but it is nowhere near as bright, nowhere near as loud, nowhere near as triumphant as it is in the South. Tailgating may not have been born here, but here is where tailgaters are born.
If you're considering joint replacement surgery, ask yourself these questions. Is my orthopedic surgeon experienced in joint replacement? Does he listen to my concerns? Explain all my options? Will he manage my pain? Will he help me regain the active life I want? The orthopedic surgeons of Palmetto Bone and Joint are proud members of Newberry Hospital's award-winning joint replacement team. We're among the best in the state and nation for hip and knee replacement. You have a choice. Palmetto Bone and Joint.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Hannah Heating and Air, Nichols Automotive, and by Printers Associates.
Welcome back to Inside Blue Hose Football. Coach, let's talk about the health of the Blue Hose there. How did we fare in the Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report?
Not too bad. You know, Damian McGee got a little head issue there on a kickoff return, actually. He went a helmet-to-helmet with one of their guys and could possibly be out. Not sure if it's a concussion or not, but he had a little blow to the head there. Otherwise, I think we're pretty good. Hopefully to get Thomas Hughes back. He's been out with an elbow, which will help us – big time on the offensive line. Joey Junius played, seemed like he was fine. You know, so for the most part, we've lost a few guys for the season, but overall we're doing pretty good.
These types of games where you talk about the option attack where you're going to get run at pretty much the whole time, you've faced four of those opponents. Does that make it, you know, more likely for injury, less likely? How does that work?
You know, that's a good question because, you know, they cut a lot. They cut your lower body a lot. They're fairly a physical, you know, Kennesaw mm-hmm. State's a really physical team. But sometimes, you know, it's kind of crazy. You know, the good, clean teams, sometimes these Division I FBS we play, everybody thinks we're going to get beat up. Mm-hmm. And actually they play so clean that you don't.
Okay,
you know,
yeah.
Sometimes it's against a lesser talented guy that accidentally rolls you up and that mm-hmm. kind of thing. So, but yeah, Kennesaw State, a physical team. So knock on wood, we came out of it pretty fair and pretty good physically.
That's great to hear. Now let's take a look at our Coach's Corner segment with offensive coordinator Todd Varn.
Coach's Corner is brought to you by Jeff Smith, Allstate Insurance of Clinton. You're in good hands with Allstate and Jeff Smith.
Welcome to this week's edition of Coach's Corner. I'm Todd Varn, offensive coordinator at Presbyterian College. And we're going to look at a big third down early in the game and the formation we were in, how we moved, and the quarterback read and the offense in front of what they're doing up front. This is early in the game, one of the first third downs we had and converted here. What we wanted to do and what we game planned was trying to change some coverage exchange on the horizontal stretch play, which we call Pony, which has a cover two beater built in it. So what we did was we cut the split by the X, which is usually a little bit wider down here near the 40. And usually he is a stem route, which pushes inside, which we've shown a lot on film, and usually eaten up by the inside backer. So what we did was motion number three over, which we hadn't shown a whole lot, to number one. Okay, so now he's replacing what the X had done in the past and what we had shown on film, which is push inside on the mic. Okay, so right now he left the X thinking the stem was not coming inside. Now we changed the stem to number three. He motioned over, and the quarterback read out, okay, this stretch, which was stressing the mic with the back, who's free releasing out in the perimeter, and the stem, which is pushing inside on the mic. Now, weak side, we had the same thing, which kind of holds the same, so the quarterback has the choice to read strong or weak. Up front, Coach Orr could put a 570 protection in, which we knew could be hot. And what it also does is, if they do leave, okay, which they are here, and only bringing three, which we did plan on bringing all of them or bringing just three, they would sift it out and sort it out, and the quarterback had a hot if they did bring them all, which they didn't here, and they moved out, and we picked it up, and Ben converted on a big third down, and Keith Pearson actually got yards after the catch, pushed it up across midfield early in the game, and a lot of momentum here early. Here again from the tight view, okay, you can see the protection up front. Okay, they sorted it out. The center hung onto the nose. Both guards are looking for work because they didn't bring all the blitz, so they're helping the tackles. Quarterback read weak, read it out on the stretch here with the back and the stem route. The corner route's not an option because the corner's sinking out of it, and Ben makes a throw to Keith. And a good football play. And that would be this week's edition of Coach's Corner.
Next week's preview is brought to you by The Bud Group. Great people, smart service.
I want to thank Coach Todd Varn there for doing the Coach's Corner. It's always fun to see him go through tape. You always learn so much. And Coach, I look forward to the week where we don't have to say this, but it's another game against a ranked team or a team that, you know, is cracking the polls again.
Yeah, it's amazing, you know, the quality. Now, everybody knows about Wake Forest and what they did to Louisville this past week. And then I guess this is six now FCS teams that probably one time or the other have been ranked mm-hmm. this year. And we're going from one extreme to the other. Seven straight home games to getting on a plane.
The farthest road trip you guys will
go
on
to. Right. Landing in LaGuardia and traveling to New Jersey. So Talk about not having an away game and all of a sudden the extreme. But we're looking forward to it, and it'll be good to get away and play a road game.
Monmouth, again, another team that's great on both sides of the ball. How are you prepared to stop them?
They got some weapons. I mean, my goodness, their quarterback is outstanding. They've got tremendous receivers. They're rushing the ball for 250 or so. They're averaging about 34 a game. They've got one of the best defensive players in the league in Mike Basile. They're shutting some people down. They're 7-1. They went to Charleston Southern, beat them 23-20. Beat Liberty pretty good, scored 59, I think, on Liberty at home just a couple weeks ago. I'm really happy for them, though, because they've been a program a little bit like us that is kind of working their way into it and have battled and struggled at times, had some good moments at times, but it's kind of clicking for them right now. Now, I'd love to ruin that for them, but they've done a good job. Real proud of them and the kind of program they've developed, and they're hot right now, playing with a lot of confidence.
A freshman running back or freshman of the week, and then they have a very strong DB and
Reggie White, the tremendous defensive lineman that played at Tennessee and the Eagles and all that. His son is one of the top receivers on their team.
So, and again, that just speaks to the quality of the Big South, where week in and week out you're going to face some of the best teams in the country.
No doubt.
Well, Coach, I appreciate you talking to us again this week. Good luck on the road.
Awesome.
Good luck on the road for the first time since August 31st this week against Monmouth.
Thank you.
For Ryan Real, Coach Spangler, we'll see you next time on Inside Blue Hose Football.
Inside Blue Hose Football was brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. And by Self Regional Healthcare.